Welcome friends to this session. Here we will discuss crank and slotted lever mechanism, which is the practical number 3 for our curriculum. Myself Nikhil Nandakishor Chavan, and I will explain this PPT to you. So theory of machine, it is the name of our subject. So what is the title? Crank and slotted lever quick return mechanism. As I mentioned earlier, what is the course outcome? We will be able to analyze and understand crank and slotted lever quick return mechanism. Content, we will see the content. So there are three topics. One is history. We will discuss introduction, historical background. The second one is theoretical background, basics of quick return mechanism, advantages and disadvantages, and its applications. And the third one is construction and working, which is very important topic as per our curriculum. So construction of a crank and slotted lever mechanism and working of crank and slotted lever mechanism. So quick return mechanism. So introduction to quick return mechanism. This mechanism is mostly used in shaping machines, slotting machines. As we know, what is shaping machine? So shaping machine is a machine which is used to make flat surfaces, horizontal, vertical, flat surfaces. Then slotting machine, which is used to make slots, and in rotary internal combustion engine. The crank and slotted quick return mechanism converts rotary motion into linear motion. So this line is important. What crank and slotted lever mechanism do? So it converts rotary motion into linear motion. It is extensively used in shaping and cutting machines, and it is particularly useful in cutting flat surfaces. So this is the significance of quick return mechanism and its applications. We will go to next slide. Basics of quick return mechanism. We will see the basics. A quick return mechanism is a mechanism that converts rotary motion into reciprocating motion at different rate for its two strokes. When the time required for the working stroke is greater than that of the return stroke, it is a quick return mechanism. So it is the significance of quick return mechanism that it utilizes less time for return stroke, and it increases the efficiency and it reduces the time required for doing a particular job. Currently, it is widely used in machine tools. For instance, shaping machines, power-driven saws, and other applications requiring a working stroke with intensive loading and return stroke with non-intensive loading. The crank rotates with uniform angular speed. Therefore, the return stroke is completed within shorter time. Thus, it is called a quick return motion mechanism. Types of quick return mechanism. So there are three types. First one is hydraulic drive mechanism. Second one is crank and slotted lever mechanism. And third one is Whitworth mechanism. We will see them one by one in the further slides. So here is a construction and its working. In this animation, we can clearly see how a quick return mechanism actually works. So this is the figure. This figure is very important. I will explain each and every part of this figure to you. So what can we see in this figure? So I will show you the part AC in this figure. So this part AC is a fixed link, which is fixed. And this is a slotted bar. In this slotted bar, there is a slider this B, which is a slider, which is link 1, and this is a crank. As you can see here, this is a crank which is rotating. This is a slider which is just sliding in this sliding block, and this slider is connected to this ram which is reciprocating, and here is the chop. So this is the important figure. So slider, this is link 1, and this is link 4, which is slotted bar. We will see its working here and its concepts. So construction and working. In this mechanism, the link AC, that is link 3. So as I mentioned earlier, this is AC, which is link 3. So this is link 3 forming the turning pair. It is forming a turning pair as shown in figure. The link 3 corresponds to connecting rod of a reciprocating steam engine. The driving crank CB revolves with uniform angular speed about the fixed center C. So I will show you. So this is C. This is C, and this is CB, which is a crank, and AP, which is a slotted block, and this crank is rotating. So the link 3 corresponds to the connecting rod of a reciprocating steam engine. The driving crank CB revolves with uniform angular speed about the fixed center C. A sliding block attached to the crank pin at B slides along the slotted bar AP and thus causes AP to oscillate about the pivoted point A. A short link PR transmit the motion from AP to the ram, which carries the tool and reciprocates along the line of stroke R1, R2. The line of stroke of the ram R1, R2 is perpendicular to AC. So here it is theoretically explained to you how it works. I will explain by myself how it really works. So this is fixed link, this is a crank, and this is a crank pin which is sliding in this sliding block. So when we give rotary motion to this crank will start rotating in clockwise direction. So because of this, the slider will start sliding in the sliding block, and this sliding block, which is AP, will oscillate from P1 to P2. So from P1 to P2, that is from CB1 to CB2, it will do its forward stroke, and from CB2 to CB1, it will do its return stroke. So in this figure, we can clearly see that the angle beta is greater than angle alpha. So time taken for completing the angle beta is obviously greater than the time taken to complete angle alpha. So here it is explained that angle beta is forward stroke and angle alpha is return stroke, and time taken for forward stroke is maximum as compared to time taken for return stroke. So this is its explanation. We will go further. In the extreme position, AP1 and AP2 are tangential to the circle, and cutting tool is at the end of the stroke. The forward or cutting stroke occurs when the crank rotates from the position CB1 to CB2 or through an angle beta in clockwise direction. The return stroke occurs when the crank rotates from position CB2 to CB1 or through angle alpha in the clockwise direction. Since the crank has uniform angular speed, therefore, so the remaining part I will explain. So this is AP, which is sliding block or slotted block, which I have explained to you earlier. So this sliding block is connected with this connecting rod to the ram, and because of the oscillation of this block, as you can see here, this is the slotted block, and because of the oscillation of this block from P1 to P2, and this connecting rod is connected to this slotted block, so it causes the ram to move horizontally, and thus we can do the work. So that is explained in that slide. So here it is how how a crank and slotted lever quick return mechanism work. So time taken of cutting stroke upon time taken of return stroke. So time taken for cutting stroke is angle beta, and time taken for return stroke, that is alpha. So its formula can be derived as beta upon 360 degree minus beta, or 360 minus alpha upon alpha. This is simple mathematics. So what are the advantages of a crank and slotted lever mechanism? So the first advantage is construction is very simple and even operating process is very easy. The second advantage is no need for high maintenance cost. As it is mentioned earlier that construction is easy, so maintenance will be less costly and there will be no need of high maintenance. The third one is working of crank and slotted lever is simple. And the fourth one is crank and slotted lever mechanism is used to converting the rotary motion of motor to reciprocating motion. So its mechanism is not so complicated. So it is very easy to operate and easy to handle. So we can use it. There are some disadvantages. So we will see the disadvantages also. So the first disadvantages is in the returning stroke, there is no contact with the work. So no cutting takes place. Hence the process takes much time to complete. So that is the first disadvantage, is that the work is taking place in only one stroke. The second stroke or the returning stroke is empty. The second disadvantage is the forward stroke takes much time compared to return stroke. Third one is it takes more power to perform operation. So and the fourth one is there is friction in the slider and piston. So there is a problem of friction. So because of friction, we need to lubricate it time to time. So these are the some disadvantages. And what are the applications of crank and slotted lever quick return mechanism? So first, it is used in shaper machine for flattening the workpiece. As we know that there is a need of a reciprocating ram in shaper machine, and that reciprocation of ram is obtained with this mechanism. So it is a very useful mechanism for shaper machine. Then same used in the slotter and planer machine. They perform similar applications. Slotter performs slotting and planer also perform the flattening process. The third one is it is also used in a screw press, mechanical actuator and rotary combustion internal engine. So these are the application of a crank and slotted lever quick return mechanism. So there is a one numerical which we will solve in this session. So I will read the problem. A crank and slotted lever mechanism used in a shaper has a center distance of 300 mm between the center of oscillation. So this 300 mm, it is the length of the fixed link and of the slotted lever. At the center of rotation of the crank, the radius of the crank is 120 mm. Find the ratio of time of cutting of the time of return stroke. So it is solved. We will see how to do the problem. So what is given? So length AC, which is 300 mm, it is given, and length CB1, which is 120 mm, it is also given. So sine of angle CB1 is what? That is sine 90 minus alpha upon 2, which is simple basic trigonometry and mathematical concept. You will understand it easily, and which is equals to CB1 upon AC. So why we are taking CB1 upon AC? Because sine theta is equals to opposite side and upon hypotenuse, and in this triangle CB1 is opposite side and AC is hypotenuse. The length of CB1 is 120 and that of hypotenuse AC is 300. So their division comes 0.4, and if we take sine inverse of 0.4, it comes as 23.6 degree. And it is alpha upon 2 equals to 90 minus 23.6, which is equals to 66.4 degree, and angle alpha equals to 2 into 66.4 degree, which is 132.8 degree. We know that time of cutting stroke upon time of return stroke, that is 360 degree. So we have seen this. So time for cutting stroke upon time of return stroke. So time of cutting stroke is 360 degree minus alpha, and time of return stroke is alpha. So 360 degree, and as we get the value which is of alpha, which is 132.8 degrees. So 360 degree minus 132.8 upon 132.8, that is 1.72 second. So this is the time required for doing a one complete stroke in crank and slotted lever quick return mechanism. So this PPT was created by Rugved Savant, Ashutosh Chitale, Harsh Datta, Sahil Gayakwad and Shreyas Gavankar, and it is explained by Nikhil Savant, Mohit Cholwar, Rahul Gade and Darshan Khaute. So thank you so much guys for giving your valuable time and listening to me.